Today I'm going to talk to you a bit about selecting technology, which is something we often get involved helping customers with. So you're at the start of a new project, it's greenfield, you've got to go out and look at all these exciting different things out there. The first thing you're going to need to do is figure out what are you going to build it with. Now there's a really, really noisy market out there when it comes to picking technology and tooling. Every vendor is going to be telling you that their thing, their piece of technology, their software is the one that's going to solve all of your problems and is going to make your world better. We all know that normally isn't the case, and it takes more than one thing to get it right. So the number one most important thing that you need to ask yourself is what type of use cases are you going to deliver? If you're trying to build some very simple business reporting, if all you want to do is just get some KPI dashboards out to some senior management teams or some business users, you're going to need a very, very different setup from a situation which has you streaming billions of records every day, doing complex machine learning on those, creating real-time recommendations or whatever it is that you're doing. So really understanding what are you trying to achieve is by far and away the number one most important thing that you need to do. But there's a load of other things you need to ask yourself. Do you have big data? And by that I mean, are you dealing with large amounts of transactions, large volumes of data, complex unstructured data that it's going to mean that you need a platform capable of scaling to large quantities of storage and processing large volumes of data. Security is another really important thing to deal with. Different platforms provide different levels of security and safety, whether that's needing encryption or whatever it is. So making sure that you've got a clear understanding of your security requirements and making sure that the platform you're picking can meet them, crucial. Thinking about whether it works for operational support, so you're going to be able to deploy it and make it run, really crucial. Should you be using open source or proprietary tooling is a really crucial one when it comes to the type of talent you're going to attract, the type of long-term support you might expect. Support itself is a really important one. Good reason to go with a vendor is if they've got a really robust and healthy support system in place that's going to make sure that you're going to be safe going forward, that you're going to be able to get the kind of response you need when you've got problems. And then there's things like, can you find a good reference customer to talk to prove that it's working for them and that you can see it in action? Things like coding language that you want to use, you know, are you Python, Java, are you building workflows in Spark, or do you prefer to use an ETL tool to wrap that up? Understanding that kind of code base that's built on is also going to be a worthwhile thing to think about in there as well. Ultimately, selecting technology is going to be a really, really crucial part of your journey, because if you don't have the right foundations, it's going to make everything you do difficult afterwards, and you don't want to realize down the line you've got those complex use cases, but you've bought the wrong thing to build them with.